angular. As you may know, angular right now is going to version 2.0. Right now it's in beta. Maybe you know already that Angular has two ways to produce code or to code. Basically, the first one is TypeScript. In fact, three ways: TypeScript, JavaScript, all JavaScript, and this third way is Dart. In this presentation, I'm going to talk about Angular and Dart and how those two get together. Basically, what I'm going to do is just follow a tutorial that appears in the page. Some of them are not completely up to date. For example, if you go to the TypeScript documentation, you see that there is one more tab here called tutorial. And here, if you go to Angular.dart, you're not going to see that tab called tutorial. So right now, what we're going to follow is the tutorial called Storing the Tab Tutorial, which has four tabs. Since this is for TypeScript, I already ported some of the code for Dart, and I have this as a kitbook, and this is the code that I'm going to follow here. If you want to follow this tutorial later, and you want to put the link into the meetup or somewhere else, I don't know. If you want to take the link, it's over there, but it's like it's a little bit small. So it's basically with gc.github.io/angular.dart. So before continuing to Angular, I think that most of you don't know what is Dart in fact. So I wanna do what you can to let me know how many of you know Dart. Nobody? How many of you know Angular? Which version? Angular 1? And Angular 2? Nobody? Okay, so before continuing with Angular, I'm just going to talk about a little bit about what is Dart. So Dart to me is the language of the future. Some companies are already using it, like Google, but not too much, because it requires a lot of time for people to code. So my name is Luis Vargas, I'm an electronic engineer. And work mostly as a software developer. I worked before in a company called Intermedics. Right now I'm working on another company called API, Advanced Processing and Imaging. In those companies, I mostly do Java and JavaScript. Java for the backend and JavaScript for the front end. My preferred language are Ruby, C#, Java, Dart, C++, and JavaScript. It's not like I love Java, it's a language that I just need to do because I get paid for that language. If somebody will give me the option, I will use Ruby instead of Java. But in any case, I just do Java for all of my job. C# is also a great language, but the problem with C# is that it's a fail language. For paid, you need to pay is like $4,000 by license by developer. Of course, there is a free version, but most of the time you need to pay the enterprise license when you go to enterprise level. Finally, C++. I think everybody who learns programming learns C++. And finally, JavaScript. Anybody that wants to do some web development needs to know a little bit about JavaScript. At least you need to know what is jQuery, at least to do web development. So, as I told you, Dart is a language created by Google, made in 2010. It's open source, it's completely free, it has batteries included, that's why they call it. And also it's a developer platform that includes language libraries, editor. And the editor, at the beginning, they begins with the editor called Dart Editor. But this one was discontinued because it was too difficult to maintain the operations of the airport. Because later on they continue with blogging for Eclipse and also IntelliJ. So they also created another editor called Grounded Editor that also was discontinued. And right now they only have blogging for Eclipse, IntelliJ and Sublime. There is also one for another editor that I don't remember. Right now I'm gonna use IntelliJ because it's the most recommended for you for developing in Dart. Dart also includes a virtual machine. So in that way, when you program your code, it's completely running a separate virtual machine. Not like TypeScript. TypeScript doesn't have a virtual machine. Finally, it also includes a browser. And the browser is basically a Chrome version with the WM included. It's called Dartune. And finally, the compiler. The compiler basically what it does is transpile code from Dart to JavaScript, similar to what GW2 does for JavaScript and JavaScript. So why that? Because, as you know, in 2008, Google creates Chrome. By that time, Chrome was the faster. Right now, it is still the fastest, as I know. And I think it's still competing with Firefox, the faster, I think, is Chrome. So they want more speed. They think that it's not enough, the speed that they get with JavaScript. So basically, this is the speed that they get in 2008, and they have been enhancing the speed from 2008, but JavaScript has a limit. So that's why they break it out. So I don't know how many of you have used one of those libraries. They require JS or something else. When you're developing in JavaScript, it happens always that you begin to require JS, then you want to add a new library like Backbone. Then Backbone is not completely compatible with Marionette or jQuery or Modernizer, and then you get this. At some point, something is going to break. I don't like this part. So where you can use that? You can use anywhere. You can use it in a server, or you can use it as a client. So as a client, you can use this induction directly, but that is mostly for development. And you can use it in other clients like Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, Opera, or Safari. But you need to transpile to JavaScript or compile before doing that. So what competitors do we have? Basically, the normal JavaScript or vanilla JavaScript. And also, we have Clojure, CoffeeScript, TypeScript, and GWT. There's a lot more, but I just mentioned those, because those are the ones that I found. Basically, the big advantage is it doesn't require to transpile to JavaScript every time that you do a new change. Your code, it does, when you do a change in your code, it goes directly to the WM. So if it doesn't happen with GWT or TypeScript, you always need to transpile. And the problem with the GWT is that it's Java, and Java is an open language, and it's old, it's like having been updated from maybe 6 almost. As I told you, it's faster than JavaScript. At the beginning, it was 10 times faster. I don't know right now. And there are some more comparisons to JavaScript, and you can find that comparisons in this webpage. I'm not sure if they still continue doing this webpage, because I think they limited it. I don't know why. So, let's do a simple tool with Angular. So my objective today is going to be what we're going to create right now is just going to be something like this one. gonna be a web page where it's gonna show all these of AO heroes. And then when you select a hero, you can edit the hero. And it's automatically binding, like we do always in Angular 1. So to do that, begin. I'm just gonna create a new project. Since I'm using IntelliJ, it's gonna be just a new project. Then I'm just gonna select that. And then I'm just gonna wait for the project templates. Select Angular 2 web application. As you can see, there are many other options like console application. This is for native applications, app engine applications, Polymer applications. This is another framework related by Google. But right now we're gonna just use Angular 2 web application. Finally, we're just gonna put a name. In this case, I'm just gonna call it Tool of Heroes. I have already one version, so I'm just going to call it Tool of Heroes 2. Okay. And just click finish. And it's for you to sign in for it. And just select new window. You can close your updates box. So this creates basically three things mostly. This file called with the spec jammer, which is the key volume to the npm file, the multi package JSON file. And also it creates the web folder and lead folder. What folder is where the files are gonna be sent to the client, what files are gonna be sent to the client, the browser. And also in the folder you're gonna see the libraries that you're gonna put inside. So to run this I just need to click run. And it's gonna be a new Windows in Dartu. This is Dartu, by the way, this is not wrong. And as you see, I can use my previous application and your app. If you come back into the HTML, I can use loading. So where does it come to my Angular app? It comes from the app component, where it says, this is the template. It says my first Angular application. And also this Angular component does that, which is the query, basically, of the components. It contains an annotation called component. And if you know, there is no JavaScript in here. So how can a browser render this? As I told you, this is Dartu. So basically, I can go to the console and see the Dart code here also. This is completely solid app. There is no JavaScript in here. There is this JavaScript, but it's a converter, not for this project, not for when you finally finalize the project. So you can find the files. Okay, you can continue here. I'm gonna close this. You can also debug from inside the application. Can you give me when I put the microphone like this? No. Okay. So you can also debug the application inside the IntelliJ, but this version of IntelliJ is the ultimate version, which costs like $200 per developer. But if you want, you don't need to pay that version. So don't use this ultimate version. If you don't want to pay this version, you can still continue debugging, but you need to debug inside the browser. You cannot debug into the IDM. So Let's continue with Tom Coates. So basically, as I told you, I'm just going to follow this tutorial. We don't need to do book setup because that is done by the IDE. When use open bootstrap channel, it appears a get dependencies, and what it does is a put get, and here put get. It's the same as we've been in the console. And when you click this button wrong, it's the same as doing a put setup. So, let me see if I find. It doesn't show here, but I think it's somewhere next here. So it's a good server. And the server port is 4884. Okay. Do you have any questions? Okay, so let's begin with the good part. Let's create a simple hero template. So here, I'm gonna go to my app template. I'm just gonna put something different here. I'm just gonna do a bit of cheating. A little bit of cheating. So I'm just gonna copy the code from here. So there is a small difference in this example. It chose from templates, but I'm gonna use template URL. It's more. I think it's beautiful to have in two different parts, the HTML and the dark code, instead of having in one single site. I'm gonna copy this. I'm gonna paste it. As you can see, there is in this template there are two variables that it's calling. The first one is title and the second one is keyword. Come from, you should put those two variables into the cat file in here. Again, I'm just going to copy it from here because it's easier instead of writing. So we're going to put those two variables, the first one called title, and this one is going to contain keyword or field, and the second one is going to be field, which is going to contain screen. So and both the variables are going to be parsed in here. And instead of showing these curly braces, I'm going to show this value of fields. So when it runs, this was one error. Let's see what happens. Okay. I need to refresh the browser. So we have here two of fields and user details like our template says. Like here. This is easier. So let's do something a little bit more difficult. Let's put, instead of hero, let's put an object called hero. And this is the difference from JavaScript and also a little bit of difference in JavaScript. In JavaScript, when you create an object, you create a function instead of an object. In Dart, you don't create a function, you create a class. Let's do that. So it should be like class. Hero. It's gonna be integer ID and also string name. And here I'm just declaring as a simple class called hero. In JavaScript you need to do a function and then the function extend the function prototype and do all that stuff. In here you don't need to do that. And then instead of calling hero, I'm just gonna say instantiate a hero, and the type is going to be hero. So, as you can see, there is an error that obviously, in JavaScript you wouldn't find. This is the error that says that the value that is print, because the type screen cannot be ascending to the hero type. So to do that, I need to create a hero, I need to instantiate the hero. In here, this is a good part from that, that you can just do dot dot again, and as you can see, it can autocomplete also. And on the scroll bar, and again, dot dot name equal minstrel. I don't know if you remember in when you're doing jQuery, you can change the values, sorry, the attributes, so that you don't do again hero ID hero name. So that's why this is dot dot. It's for changing purposes. I think you can do this in TypeScript. I'm not completely sure how can you do it in TypeScript. Okay. So we have a new hero with ID 1 and with the name being stored. Let's run again our code. Okay, so here we see instance of hero. This is an object, this is not like in JavaScript, that all objects are max. In that, only max are max. Objects are objects, so you don't get that the parse weight of the string in JSON format. At least you implement the toString function into the object. I'm not gonna do that. So to show the name, instead of, I'm just gonna put hero.name. Now that is installed. That was easy, no? Do you have any question at the moment? No. I don't know if that's good or bad, because that would mean to think you're not understanding anything or they're not understanding anything. So let's continue. What about if I want to put let's say it's an input, and in that input I want to edit the name of my hero. So let's go again to app component and just wanna put an input. Here, I'm just going to put a new div and an input. Let's go here, label. Let's call it. So, in here, the thing that I need to do is just value and then pass the value of the hero name. Yes. I'm just going to debug it here instead of just running. The big advantage of debugging is that it auto-refresh the browser. So in here, you see Winstorm, but there is a problem. When you edit Winstorm, it doesn't appear, it doesn't get edited. So to do that in a new version of Angular, you need to use two-way binding. And to do that, the new version is doing with ng-model. But to use ng-model, you need to use also a new way of created that to use that ng model. Before it was something like just ng model. But this is not the new way. The new way, it should be using brackets and also parentheses. So in this way, we are doing two things. The bracket means assignment, and the parenthesis means event, on event. So brackets mean body, and parenthesis means on. This is the new way of doing using ng model in Angular. Yeah, we're here. I'm using a template instead of using an assignment, and it should be without the curly braces. So now when I edit my form, it also auto-binds. This is similar to the previous version. The only difference is that you use the brackets and the parentheses. Let's do something a little bit more difficult. Let's create a list of heroes. And then after that, render and select one hero and do what we did in the sample. Since that out of code, I'm going to do that all. I'm just going to copy the list of heroes. Then I'm just going to create a new list of heroes. This is good about that. I'm going to show you that. Let's go to a component of that. And here, I just want to show you the same that we did with new hero here. We are creating one hero for every, we're creating 10 heroes. We're following the dot-dot assignment that we did before, and also using dot-dot-name, dot-dot-id. In here, I'm just creating a global variable. Dart is not like Java. In Java, you cannot create global variables. In Dart, you can create global variables, similar to JavaScript. But also, in the Dart example, you're going to find that this is a constant. If I put constant here, it's gonna show me an error. It's gonna show me this, all of this should be constant. So this should be constant. And also the heroes should be constants instead of being a new instance. Then you should continue like this. But in this case, I don't want to use constants, because in fact, this is a list of heroes, and I want to change it in the future. So it's variable, not a constant. And this is a tiny difference from JavaScript also, because in JavaScript doesn't exist the constants per se. It exists final, I think, but not constant. And final is not the same as constant, because final is a variable with one setting time, at least. So next step is going to be just render all those heroes into our page. So I'm just going to create a new variable called heroes with a plural, and it's going to be a list. And this list is going to be equal to the heroes. So basically, I'm just assigning these heroes to these other variable, other attribute fields, and then I'm just gonna use in the template here. So here I'm just gonna do an ng repeat, similar to what we did before, we do before in Angular 1. In Angular 1, it does like ng repeat. In here it's not the same ng repeat, but it's similar. So it's gonna be ng repeat with comma space. And also there is something new that we could also add a little asterisk before. And here is when we do the ng repeat. Also, we don't do, we assign a variable for hue of hues. Here, as you see, to create a new variable, in that is just doing with the little chart, the little pound symbol. If you don't do with the little pound, it doesn't create any variable. So now I'm just gonna put the ID and the name in a batch. I'm just gonna copy the next code because it's a little bit long. Let's see. So is this code what I want? So this is missing. So basically what I'm doing is just creating a span, and inside that span it's going to be the hero ID, and the hero name for every hero. So let's put this in another. So next, the next step is just run again this. Oh yes, it's not accurate, sorry, I said before. Now, as you see, this. So basically two changes were that instead of accurate, it's MG4, I'm also using this asterisk here, and also using this this pound sign, the dollar sign. The rest is almost the same templates as before. And basically here we have the element starting point. Basically now we only need to do some styling to put it better. Right? So I'm just gonna copy the styles also because that's long. So. Those are the styles, and something new is that you can add the styles inside Dart code or TypeScript code. So I'm just gonna copy all of these. Instead of creating a new style sheet, I just can add the style directly to the Dart code. So to add that, I need to add it into the annotation, inside the annotation here. The annotation is where you put basically all the metadata for the components. I forgot to tell something before, is that Angular 2 doesn't have controllers. It's now called component. And also, you have two options, or using component or using directive, but not controller anymore. So here I'm just going to add the CSS style. So if we go all those styles here, as I told you before, it's not good to put all the styles in the same dark code, because you have too much code that is not in the same page. It is already the same. It's too much code in the same file. I would prefer to put this code in a different CSS file. To do that, you can just create a new CSS file and reference here in these styles. But I'm not going to do that because I'm not completely sure of that today. If later you can try it, you can do it for yourself. So let's see what happens. Something good about that is that I just need to click very wrong, and it's going to auto refresh the browser. In JavaScript, you can do it with Node, but you need to run Node in the background and always checking or watching the files. And here it's not needed because the Dart environment do it for you. You don't need to do anything else. Something that I want to show you also is that, is the PostScript Java. In this file, it's where you specify the dependencies that you are using. I'm just using two dependencies, and you have browser. And also the SDK and transformers. Transformers are like tasks in Go or Run. Similar, not the same. Okay, let's see. It looks that the styles didn't get correct. Okay. If we look again into our files, I didn't put classes to my list, so that's why I didn't put these styles correctly. So the classes that I need are being hero and let me see. Heroes and batch. So the next step will be to select one of those, and when I select one of these one, it should be selected here, right? So to do that, I just need to create an event called onSelect, and I'm going to put this event inside the list. And the event is going to be onClick. So to do onClick, I just need to do click inside parentheses equal onSelect, and then I'm just going to pass the hero that I'm selecting. I need to create also this function inside the Dart code here. This function is the hero. And then I'm just going to do hero equals hero. I'm just going to rename this one to call it selected hero. Then whenever I call this function from onClick, onSelect, which is this function here. This function is just going to pass, it's going to put this selected here to the hero, to this attribute. Something interesting about that is optional type. So if you don't want to put the type always, you can just remove it. And it's going to run equally. Let's see what's happening. Which one? Yeah, but what I'm doing is just passing this body, this heel, to this function on the heel. So let's see what happens here in the... this is not right, it's selected here. That's also bad about the code, that you cannot just go to the code just to complete. But maybe in the future they think that they're gonna add something for doing this. I don't know right now, but when you rename a variable, it's gonna be renamed also in HTML files, but now you do that by hand. So now we have the list. So that this one is going to be Mr. Mike Dells. Now there is something that we are missing. It's just that. So we are missing just something, is that we have too much template. The template that we have is too big. We want to have it in different files. We have to have. For example, this part, I will call it, all this part, I will call it heels form, and all this part, I will call it heel list. To do that, I just need to create two new components called heel form and heel list. In that, I create a library, something to do that easier, instead of doing it by hand, creating two files, and I call the ng2gen. You can, to use it, you only need to do pull global activate ng2gen. This is my creation. So it don't know this program from the pub server, and install it into the machine into a file called cache. If you want to use it, you only need to do pull global run ng2gen, but it's too long, so you can also add the folder to your platform. Then that's what I did. Then I just need to do ng2gen the new component, right? So I need to go to the lit folder, and then I just need to do ng2gen component, and then that's called hero form component. This one creates a new folder. So this creates a new folder called hero form component, and inside the two files that I need. And also it put the selector and everything, the boilerplate code. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is just pass the code from the app component to here. So this one is gonna be our front component template. From the app component part, I need to pass selector here. Okay, so we have an error here that we need to import this hero class. So instead of importing the app component, I'm just going to create a new file called hero to have that model in a different place. And here is where I'm going to put the hero details, the hero class. Then I just need to import that model into the front component. To do that, I can just do alt enter and then import library, and the error disappears. Doing this in JavaScript will be a complete headache because you cannot just do this. You need to do everything by hand. You can go to the hero code, just control click and go to the hero class directly. JavaScript could be also a headache to do that. So now we also need to reference our component into our app component. So here we need to put the reference could be hero component. So this hero form component is gonna have the hero, it's gonna handle the form. So basically I'm gonna leave this code that is not needed. Okay, and then I'm just gonna create a component for the list. I'm gonna do the same as before in G2Gen. Hero list. So our component is going to have these two elements. And then again, we just need to import that library. And also I need to, I'm just going to create another file called heroes mock, so that I'm going to put the list of heroes in a different file. I also need to import the hero. And finally, I also need to import the heroes here. And also, the selected hero is not here, so the selected hero is I camera, just referencing the hero selected. Okay. What else do we have there? So this install is basically not for the app component, it's for the list component. I don't want this install here. I'm going to leave it here by the moment. Right before. This template is not going to be here, it's going to be in the list template. And then in the app component HTML, I just need to reference the template. You know, this component. Then here I'm just referencing two components. So that's what is top down. The top one is the app component, and then it goes down to the hero component, and finally to this component. So what do we have here? This one is. So let's see what happens. Of course, I need to do something else. Let's see what happens now. Right now it's not going to load because I have an error. I'm not sure there is the error. So the error basically is that I haven't referenced the directive. We have this component directive into the app component directive for component. So I choose to pass directive. So we have now the list of heroes, and also it's hidden the front component. Why it is hidden, I don't know, but let's see what happens. Interesting is that we need to pass which component we have selected at the moment. Sorry, which hero. To do that, we need to pass this as a attribute. Sorry, I'm just going to call selected hero equal. So I need to reference this as hero this. And then pass the variable. Hero this dot selected hero. Okay. Also, I need to pass this as an input, so this should be in brackets instead of normal attribute. Let's see what else. Then this is something. I think we are not in time, so. I don't know what happens here.
Okay. I don't know what happens. See your email box. See me so I don't have any time for questions. Basically, what it should do is something like this. It should show the hill. You see, the only difference that I need to add also the input, but this is just to pass by. I don't know if you have any questions. I know that it's not enough time, but so basically this is a little introduction for that. I'm gonna find that error. I don't know why happened. So thank you for coming.